love the box framelit. You're gonna need those. You need a 4x4 piece of cardstock, and you're gonna take, this is the bottom of the box right down here. And you're gonna take and you're gonna score it 1/2 inch along all four sides for that. Okay, you need some good
tear tape.
All right. So we need a couple pieces of scrap of white, one that's 1/2 inch and one that's a little, that's about 1 inch piece of scrap. And then this is for the circle on the front here, powder pink, and we're gonna punch a circle, 3/4 circle out of that, and we'll get back to that. Let's put this box together real quick. So when you put the box together, you need to put the flaps to the inside, like this. Okay, you don't want the flaps to the outside. So we need to run a piece of tape down here. Tabs off, and I always cut at an angle. Okay, so there's your box. This is bent back. Let's go ahead and put the sides on it, because what I've done is designer series paper. It's part of the suite. And the reason why I cut them 3x4 was because you get the best utilization out of the 12x12 cardstock if you cut them this size. And I'm just going to run it down here to the bottom because this flap's going to hang down anyways. See? So I'm just not going to worry about the top. I'm going to use green glue for this. Sides only, and that's what we're going to do with it. I'm also going to reach up in here and clip some of these away. Thank you. going to be to work on this front. Let me show you this circle because that's really cool. So on this circle, I just punched one out. And then I took my snail adhesive. Now this is a silicone pad, so my snail will get on there, but it won't stick. And I'm just covering it with snail. My glitter. I'm just gonna kind of there we go. So that circle's done. Now for this other circle on the front here, this one here, all I did was I went and I grabbed my layering circles and took the second to the largest, cut it out using the scallop circle through the Big Shot. Then I ran it through this Sweetheart embossing folder. Now this is in the annual catalog, and of course right up in here somewhere is where I ran it through. Decorative design, and we're gonna take, we're gonna sponge a little bit, and I'm using Melon Mambo. This cardstock is Melon Mambo. I like sponging it because I like that little design to really show off, pop up, stand out. Okay, so that piece is done. So then let's work on Happy Birthday Banner. Now the birthday banner comes out of the framelits and the stamp set. So here's the Sure Do Love You stamp set. So I used this, stamped it in powder pink. All right, and then I'm gonna grab the framelit. It came with it. And we're gonna, this would be a good one to have the magnetic board out of our annual catalog. I do not happen to have one close by, so I'm not going to use it. So an alternative to that would be to line up your post, your stamped image and your framelit, and then lock it down with the post-it note. This is also out of the stamp set, just for you. Now on this box, the pre-made box, I did Happy Birthday, because I need a Happy Birthday gift. But you might, you know, you just might want to make it just for you, because it might be for something else. So I grabbed the Just For You, and I stamped it on a piece of scrap paper. This piece of scrap paper, that's Melon Mambo. I'm going to measure it to make sure I get enough. Just clip the ends. Grab dimensional. Now make sure I didn't clip it too short. Nope. Do this with any words that fit right in there. Of our circle. I'm probably going to use, I'm going to use glue. Hopefully I haven't got a mess. So I'm going to bring in my silicone pad. That way I won't get it all over my work surface. I'm going to move it up a little bit. There we go. My little created down here, just to give it something interesting. And then I, if you'll notice, I took and just put, laid down little bits of glue to get my little glitter. So So you can use your green glue, but it doesn't take very much. I almost have too much there. And I'm only gonna put three down because that's what we're supposed to do, is only use three for the creativeness. Technically, the circle could have been three, but I like using glitter. I like things that are glittery. I'm gonna take and just dip the tip of my paper piercer in the glue. And then I'm gonna go in. Okay, so let's move on to how to decorate the edges of the box here, the little lip that we're gonna glue down this guy. How do we get this perfect margin all the way around? So to do that, we're going to go back and we're going to get our box. But this time we're going to cut a piece of designer series paper that is 2 3/4 by 2 inches. And it, what I did is I ended up using the leftover from this, because this is the same width. I just made it 2 inches. So that's the leftover. And we're going to run that through the Big Shot. Now, I did go and grab my magnet. Guys could see how nice. I don't have to use the post-it note. It holds it pretty good. A lot of times though, we don't change out our acrylic plates and they become warped, and the magnetic board does not work as well. So, and all you need to do with this is just, it's just the top that you're doing. So I'm gonna cut it back. I'm gonna cut it back to see how it gave us a score. Okay, so to make this nice, a nice edge, I'm gonna put the middle where you can see it. Box almost landed up in my ink pad, so I've got to close them. I'm gonna line this up right on the 1 1/4 inch, right there. Up there, kind of. I mean, there's nothing to balance it on, so I'm gonna have to eyeball it, make sure it runs, it's setting on that line, and then you gotta hold it. Remember, let's see what that looks like. I think that's gonna be nice. Yep, that's perfect. See how it gives you a nice margin all the way around? So I need to do that on all three other pieces. Let's just glue all these puppies down. Okay, there we go. And then I'm going to put a dimensional behind each one of the flaps. Against the box. You can always stick some paper down in there if you don't want it to. There's that. Oh, and then we got to put our little just for you on there. And I think I'm going to stick it on with dimensionals so that it stands out the same distance from the lid.